Whether they're in-depth portraits of underrepresented areas of society or detailed accounts of bizarre crimes, documentaries are an indispensable form of entertainment and education. We love them because they can keep us on the edges of our seats like thrillers, warm our hearts like family dramas, and make us laugh like comedies, all while helping us learn something. While it's perhaps not as well known as a certain other streaming giant for its library of original documentaries, Amazon Prime Video has a lot to offer in the genre. With these pieces, you can look inside the lives of everyone from famous actors to largely anonymous booksellers and, believe it or not, murder victims. No matter what you're into, Amazon's streaming service has a documentary for you. Updated on August 16, 2021. There are dozens of compelling documentary films and series available on Prime Video, and that library is constantly being updated. This list reflects the best documentaries you can currently catch on Prime, so be sure to check back each month for new additions to the streaming service. Val, if you haven't seen Val Kilmer around lately, you might be wondering what he's been up to. The answer may surprise you. Since 2017, he's been public about his diagnosis of throat cancer, a sickness he beat but that has resulted in diminished use of his voice as well as difficulty eating. That doesn't mean that Kilmer has really lost his voice, though. In a searingly authentic look at his life in his own words, narrated poignantly by his son, we see him at his most vulnerable, and we love him even more. Maybe it's because we're finally seeing him through his own camera lens, which he's been using to document his life since childhood, instead of someone else's. Directors. Leo Scott, Ting Pu Year, 2021 Runtime, 108 minutes rating. R Rotten Tomatoes score, 93%. Long Strange Trip. The title of the documentary, Long Strange Trip, refers to a quintessential Grateful Dead lyric from their 1970 song, Truckin', but it could also be understood as a nod to the film's four-hour runtime. Panda Express is one of America's favorite restaurant chains. The line, "What a long, strange trip it's been," has taken a journey of its own on the way to cultural immortality. Like many other lyrics and the Dead themselves, it's been referenced, parodied, imitated, and honored more times than we can count. The 2017 documentary is yet another homage, this time featuring fresh interviews with living band members, relevant colleagues, and friends. Oh, and it's executive produced by Martin Scorsese. If anyone knows when a long movie is worth watching, it's the director of The Irishman. Directors. Amir Bar-Lev Year, 2017 Runtime, 238 minutes rating. R Rotten Tomatoes score, 100%. Dear Zachary. A letter to a son about his father. When you die, what do you want to leave behind for your children? Both death and legacy are often out of our control. But in the case of Andrew Bagby, who was found murdered after he broke up with a woman named Shirley, he had some friends and family who cared deeply enough about him to create a cinematic scrapbook of his life. This way, his son Zachary, whom Shirley announced she was pregnant with after she became a murder suspect, could one day come to know him. But, Dear Zachary, A Letter to a Son About His Father doesn't just chronicle the past. It traces the evolution of Zachary's story as it unfolds, and makes a tragic but important point about how we care for vulnerable children. Directors. Kurt Kuen Year, 2008 Runtime, 93 minutes rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, 94%. Sunshine Hotel, Sunshine Hotel, the first documentary by filmmaker and photojournalist Michael Dominic, is less about the building located at 245 Bowery in Manhattan, and more about the lives of the people who inhabited it. The titular establishment was a flophouse, a single-room occupancy residence designed for low-cost lodging. Set up like a Chinese hot bar with a wide array of westernized Chinese cuisine, Panda Express is designed to meet your cravings for delicious, salty, tangy goodness. The restaurant chain prides itself on bringing people together with joy over dishes specially created to honor the flavors of Chinese cuisine. They view their core team, guests, and associates as family, and they are a classic family-run business that started with Master Chef Ming Tsai Cherng designing the menu and CEOs Peggy and Andrew Cherng managing the restaurant. As the Sunshine Hotel's formerly notorious neighborhood became increasingly gentrified, Michael Dominic created one of the last links to its colorful history and the unforgettable people who called it home. Directors. Michael Dominic Year, 2001 Runtime, 98 minutes rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, 93%. Audience score, Lorena Warning. Graphic content in this slide. Now, Panda Express has deeply impacted the way Americans eat Chinese food. Chief Brand Officer Andrea Cherng, who is the granddaughter of the chef that changed everything, put it best in her statement on the company's values. The dishes my grandfather helped inspire have become the definition of not only American Chinese comfort food, but simply American comfort food, she said, per Panda Express. One of its top dishes is the honey walnut shrimp, which you might have guessed if you associated the name of the documentary, Lorena, with Lorena Bobbitt. The dish has many devoted fans who swear by it and would never order anything else. Whether you're one of the menu option's biggest fans or if you've never tried it before, everything you need to know before ordering Panda Express honey walnut shrimp is detailed below. What is honey walnut shrimp? Honey walnut shrimp is a dish that has roots in traditional Chinese food, but has become a ubiquitous standard with a unique recipe in westernized Chinese food. Unsurprisingly, the story of a wife who cut off her husband's penis while he was sleeping has sort of been lost in the hurricane of tabloid sensation and off-color humor that immediately sprang up around the scandal when it happened. Lorena offers us a truer, more intimate look at the humans behind the legend, yes, both of them. Lorena claimed she was retaliating against domestic violence and sexual assault. John also details his memory of the events leading up to the incident. Executive produced by Jordan Peele, Lorena is both a moral inquiry and a wild ride. Directors: Joshua Rofeyer, 2019 runtime, 4 hours 14 minutes, 4 episodes, rating: TVMA Rotten Tomatoes score: 82%. The New Yorker presents: Did you ever buy one of those super discounted New Yorker subscriptions? Maybe one of the ones with the free tote bag, and then watch the subscriptions pile up each month without reading a single article? Well, now you can get some of that New Yorker content you've been feeling guilty about missing, and you don't have to turn a single page. It is exactly what the name implies: shrimp with walnuts in a mayonnaise honey sauce. The Panda Express recipe coats the shrimp in a tempura batter, fries them up, and tosses them in a wok with glazed walnuts and their signature honey sauce that does not include mayonnaise. Melissa Hung described how the dish likely originated in Hong Kong and was brought to the United States in the 80s and 90s, via Resi. The dish has become a phenomenon and can be found on many Chinese restaurant menus around the country. It has been available at Panda Express since 2010, when their version of it debuted to a hungry and excited reception. The dish even won the Menu Masters Award for Best New Menu Item that year, via Panda Express. How much does it cost? The cost of your meal at Panda Express depends on how you order it, what portion size you get, and location, but there are some standard rates for the honey walnut shrimp at the different serving options. It is considered a premium entree option with an extra charge, so it is a bit more expensive than the other typical offerings like orange chicken when ordered as part of a meal or bowl. A small, medium, or large serving of just the honey walnut shrimp by itself costs $5.45, $10, and $13.95, respectively. Instead, try, The New Yorker presents, a multimodal exploration of art that blends documentary with poetry and animation. Directors: multiple directors over various episodes. Year, 2015 runtime, multiple episodes, 30 minutes each. Rating: M. Rotten Tomatoes score, 86%. Ted Bundy: falling for a killer. There's no shortage of serial killer films in the modern canon, from dramatizations to documentaries. But the true crime docuseries, Ted Bundy: Falling for a Killer, purports to tackle the story of one of history's most infamous killers from a new vantage point. This work elevates the perspective of Bundy's victims rather than glamorizing him for entertainment value, and also situates his pathological, woman-hating persona in the feminist cultural context he inhabited at the time. It's a look at Bundy as you've likely never seen him before. Directors: Trish Woodyer, 2020 runtime, 3 hours 51 minutes, 5 episodes. Rating: TVMA Rotten Tomatoes score, 80%. Chivas: El Rebaño Sagrado CD Guadalajara, the popular Mexican professional football club, is more often known by their nickname, Chivas. As part of the $20 family feast, expect to pay an extra $3.75 for honey walnut shrimp. If you order it with a single plate or bowl, the price will increase $1.25. A kid's meal with this entree will cost $6.15, via fast food menu prices. For the amount of food you get, these seem like fair prices that give you some bang for your buck. Why does honey walnut shrimp cost more? The slightly higher cost of the honey walnut shrimp at Panda Express is definitely one of the main downsides of ordering the dish and may leave some customers wondering why the extra price is worth it.
This dish isn't the only one on the menu with an upcharge. Whenever there is a shrimp option at Panda Express, like the honey walnut shrimp or the firecracker shrimp, the price includes the premium upcharge. When asked on Twitter what the charge was for, the official Panda Express Twitter account explained it. This is the Spanish word for goat, and it actually sprang out of an insult from fans of Club Atlas, one of the Chivas' chief rivals. The extra cost is meant to cover the difference in ingredient costs. but they reclaimed the nickname with affection over time, and rightfully so. The team has all the strength, stubbornness, and adaptability of their namesakes. Chivas. El Rebaño Sagrado, follows the team after the death of their legendary owner Jorge Vergara in November 2019. The shrimp costs more than traditional entree ingredients like chicken or vegetables, and this cost is passed on to the customer when they order the premium ingredient. His son Amori inherits the responsibility, but he also inherits scandals and feuds, just in time for the pandemic to begin. A story of struggle, triumph, and heart, Chivas is an unforgettable sports documentary. Directors. A year. 2021 runtime. Varying lengths. 4 episodes. Rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score. A free Meek, Dreams and Nightmares. Rapper Meek Mill was embroiled in a battle with the U.S. justice system for 12 years beginning in 2007. It is this battle that takes center stage in Free Meek, which follows the seemingly predatory actions of Mill's judge, who repeatedly sent him back to prison for minor alleged parole violations. This does make sense and is worth it for die-hard fans of the premium dishes or anyone with a specific hankering for the Panda Express shrimp. What does it taste like and is it good? The consensus on Panda Express honey walnut shrimp is that the dish is very tasty and definitely worth ordering, although the price is considered to be a bit high. YouTuber Big Daddy's World gave the dish an 8 out of 10, as he enjoyed the flavor of the shrimp and the experience of eating it, but found the price to be a little bit high. Bite and Chew Food Review on YouTube also enjoyed the honey walnut shrimp, commenting on the large size of the shrimp, the satisfyingly crispy coating, and the delicious and sweet flavor that didn't overwhelm with its sweetness. Both Mill and rapper Jay-Z executive produced the project, and they also co-founded the Reform Alliance, which focuses on reforming the justice and probationary systems. Directors. A year. 2019 runtime. 33 to 48 minutes. 5 episodes. Rating. TVMA Rotten Tomatoes score. 100% The Tesla Files. If you're like a lot of modern consumers, you may not have cable anymore, but you can still catch some History Channel specials on various streaming services. He also described the shrimp as tender and juicy and gave the shrimp itself a 10 out of 10 rating. Amazon Prime has a particularly interesting option available, The Tesla Files, which is part documentary, part dramatization, all mystery regarding the man who might have revolutionized the modern world, if not for his untimely and suspicious death. Directors. A year. 2018 runtime. 43 minutes per episode. 5 episodes. Rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score. A rewind. Imagine if people could play events of their lives back, looking to reconstruct evidence of abuse. One might want to find the answers, but it would also be incredibly painful to relive. The main negative in his review was also the high price point. Not all the reviews were completely positive, however. There is one family at the center of Rewind, but the camcorder footage from the family's past reveals multiple instances of child abuse, as well as the events surrounding these instances. The documentary is serious stuff, and 3 prosecutions came out of the ordeal. The documentary leaves us and its subjects with hope that through looking back and gaining closure, survivors of abuse may find the strength to move forward. Directors. Sasha Neulinger. Year. 2019 runtime, 86 minutes. Rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score. 100% The Booksellers. There are a lot of movies based on books, but how many movies do you know of that are actually about books? On the surface, it may not sound like the most exciting premise, but The Booksellers offers what amounts to a magical window into the world of rare book dealing in New York City, featuring prominent authors and personalities along the way. Directors. D.W. Young. Year. 2019 runtime. 99 minutes. Rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score. 90% Nas. Time is Illmatic. In April of 1994, Nas released his debut album, Illmatic. 20 years later, almost to the day, Nas. Time is Illmatic premiered at the Tribeca Film Festival and offered a detailed account of the events that led up to the album's release.
From his parents' influence to his memories of youth, Nas takes us through the experiences and emotions that went into his landmark achievement. Directors. 19 Year, 2014 runtime, 74 minutes. Rating. TV 14. Rotten Tomatoes score, 98% sensitive. The Untold Story. If you're reading this with the brightness on your screen turned down. Thrillist described the honey walnut shrimp as goopy, overly sweet, and lacking in crispy crunch. Nutritional information on honey walnut shrimp. The honey walnut shrimp at Panda Express is fairly healthy, although it's certainly not the healthiest food option. There isn't a total consensus on whether the dish is healthy or not. Eat This, Not That included it on the bottom of its list of healthy meals at the restaurant, but Very Well Fit named it one of the unhealthiest options. If you cry easily and can see yourself shedding a tear over some of the items on this list. At the end of the day, it is a fried dish with sugar from honey, so it's not going to be considered a health food by any measure. If you will let your heart guide you when you choose which one to watch. You might be a highly sensitive person. These aren't all of the tendencies that describe a temperament trait that's found in 20% of the population. Sensitive. The Untold Story offers both self-acceptance and self-exploration, and does so scientifically, for anyone who might have felt or been told they're too sensitive, or have someone in their life who fits the description. Directors. Will Harper. Year, 2015. Runtime, 63 minutes. Rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, N.A. Fed up on the back of pretty much every package of food in America, there's a little box full of information. At the top of that box, its bold and unequivocal title promises nutrition facts. But in terms of nutrition in America, there are a lot of facts missing, and even willfully hidden, from the public eye. A label might tell you what's in a product, but you don't know exactly how those elements will affect you. The nutritional values for the dish are listed on the Panda Express website, along with similar information for everything else on their menu. For a 3.7-ounce serving, there are 360 calories, 260 of which come from fat. The total fat is 23 grams, with 3.5 grams of saturated fat and 0 grams of trans fat. Fed Up details how, through lobbying and misinformation, the health of the big sugar industry won out over the health and informedness of the American people. Directors. Stephanie Soakdig. Year, 2014. Runtime, 92 minutes. Rating, PG. Rotten Tomatoes score, 80%. Beats, rhymes, and life. The travels of A Tribe Called Quest. The hip-hop group A Tribe Called Quest was a revolutionary force. Though the original members of the group have had their ups and downs, both individually and as an ensemble, their words and their name remain a legend in the alternative hip-hop world. With a score composed by Madlib, the documentation of The Tribe's travels is sure to please any hip-hop fan. And whether or not the genre is your favorite, this intimate portrait of four pioneering individuals will leave you with lots to think about in terms of art, friendship, and life. Directors. Michael Rapaport. Year, 2011. Runtime, 97 minutes. Rating, R. Rotten Tomatoes score, 90%. The Mystery of Chaco Canyon, with the tagline, America's Stonehenge. You can be certain that The Mystery of Chaco Canyon will raise all kinds of interesting questions about humanity, civilization, and life on Earth. Whether it answers those questions is an entirely different issue, but you'll find this documentary about massive ceremonial structures built to align with celestial patterns engaging either way. Even though the documentary is more than two decades old, the millennia-old mystery comes alive in this film. And unanswered questions are part of the magic. Directors. Anna Sofayer. Year, 1999. Runtime, 56 minutes. Rating, not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, N.A. Hash Unfit. The Psychology of Donald Trump. Before, during, and after his tenure as commander-in-chief, members of the public have speculated as to the mental state of Donald Trump. While mental illness itself certainly doesn't preclude a person from the ability to hold public office, the particular behavior exhibited by the former president prompted a lot of conjecture among laypeople. Now, in hashtag unfit, the psychology of Donald Trump, we get licensed psychologists take on the questions many members of the public have been asking themselves for years about the seeming narcissism, paranoia, and sadism of the, formerly, most powerful man on the planet. Directors. Dan Partland. Year, 2020. Runtime, 83 minutes. Rating, not rated. The Sunshine Makers. The 1960s are basically synonymous with counterculture, and at the center of that counterculture was one, mind-expanding, substance, LSD. The cholesterol level of the dish is 100 milligrams. During that far-out decade, underground chemists Nicholas Sand and Tim Scully produced millions of hits of acid and awakened a psychedelic revolution in America, all while dodging the law like a real-life Walter White and Jesse Pinkman. The Sunshine Makers illuminates an astonishing era of history and two of the people who helped define it. Directors. Cosmo Fielding. Mellon. Year, 2015. Runtime, 101 minutes. Rating, not rated. Citizen 4. One of the closest things to a thriller on this list, Citizen 4 is riveting cinema whether you're looking to learn or sweat. There are 35 grams of carbohydrates, including 2 grams of dietary fiber and 9 grams of sugar. It is unique because the documentarian behind the narrative actually takes part in it at the same time. The sodium content is 440 milligrams. Bottom line, if you are looking to eat especially healthy, then the honey walnut shrimp is probably not the ideal dish. The picture that Laura Poitras paints is one of the most intimate looks we get at Edward Snowden in the wake of the NSA spying scandal, and we find ourselves looking on anxiously as the lives of both Poitras and Snowden, and the trust of Americans in their institutions, are turned upside down. Directors. Laura Poitras year, 2014 runtime, 113 minutes rating. Are The Imposter. The Imposter is the perfect mix of documentary elements, archival TV footage, a peppering of reenactments, and most importantly, interviews with both sides of an elaborate true crime-style scam. It's quite dramatic for a documentary, told with true narrative cohesion and profound sensitivity to its subject matter. And that subject matter seems almost too insane to be true. Frederick Bourdain, while impersonating a missing child, whom he looked nothing like, somehow managed to trick not only several government agencies in the United States and Spain, but members of the child's own family. If there's room in your diet for some wiggle room, then it could be a good choice. Getting to know this odd character is one of the most compelling parts of the film, as his childlike charisma clashes with his lack of remorse for taking advantage of a grieving family. Directors. Bart Layton year, 2012 runtime, 99 minutes rating. Our Zeitgeist, the first of a three documentary series, Zeitgeist. The movie was originally released online in 2007, after which it quickly amassed millions of views and a, maybe literally, cult following. It was almost as quickly condemned by the media at large, because it's filled to the brim with conspiracy theories revolving around everything from the American finance system to astrological events and terrorism. But it's a fascinating window into the questions people have about the world, and there is genuine truth and inquiry mixed in with the fantastical bits. Trying to parse that out, without tumbling fully down the rabbit hole, is a wild ride in itself. Directors. Peter Joseph year, 2007 runtime, 118 minutes rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, 86%, audience score, no. A documentary on the face of it, no. A documentary, looks like a sports treatment, and sports fans will certainly enjoy it for those elements. But its depiction of addiction and fame, buoyed by colorful images and a 70s soundtrack, will delight viewers of any background. Doc Ellis' life and baseball career, including the no-hitter he pitched while on LSD, are just plain interesting, whether you're an avid sports fan or not. Directors. Jeff Radis year, 2014 runtime, 100 minutes rating. Not rated. Bones Brigade. An autobiography. For many years, skateboarding held the reputation of a pastime at best and a public nuisance at worst, and there were definitely people out there who would scoff to consider it a sport. But over time, the passionate practitioners of the craft have earned a place for skateboarding as both an industry and an athletic discipline. The sport even made its debut as an Olympic event at the 2021 Tokyo Games. In Bones Brigade, an autobiography, we get a look into the lives of the skateboarders and entrepreneurs, including Tony Hawk, whose passion and determination helped build the sport into the sensation it is today. Directors. Stacy Peralta year, 2012 runtime, 90 minutes rating. P.G. Travis. The true story of Travis Walton. There are plenty of alleged alien abduction cases that have been summarily debunked, or were never convincing enough in the first place to warrant any further investigation. But this story is different. Travis. The true story of Travis Walton is not the first film to be made about the titular former forestry worker's alleged UFO abduction. It's become one of the most recognized stories of its kind in pop culture. Fire in the Sky famously dramatized the incident in 1993. But this 2015 documentary is better than a dramatic interpretation. We get to hear from Walton himself and decide on our own whether to believe him.
Directors. Jennifer Stein year, 2015 runtime, 90 minutes rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, N.A. Lucy and Daisy. A home movie who could tell the story of Lucille Ball, Daisy Arnaz, and their family better than the couple's own daughter, Lucy Arnaz? Lucy and Daisy. A home movie is just like any other home movie, except that the first-hand family footage depicts two of the most famous people in the country at the time. Along with video from Ball and Arnaz's home life, their daughter has compiled interviews with friends, you know, chums like Bob Hope, family, and colleagues to really flesh out the image of a TV couple who seemed larger than life to their I Love Lucy audiences but, to the director of the film, were just mom and dad. Directors. Lucy Arnaz year, 1992 runtime, 108 minutes rating. Not rated. Rotten Tomatoes score, 86%, audience score. Time. In a moment of desperation, a husband and wife committed an armed bank robbery. But the American justice system left no room for their side of the story when it sentenced Rob G. Rich to spend a large chunk of his life in prison. Since then, his wife Fox Rich, who served 3.5 years, has been campaigning for his release. She helps tell their story, that of their family and their struggle for justice, in the poignant documentary, Time. Directors. Garrett Bradley Year, 2020 runtime, 81 minutes rating, PG-13 Dior and I. Even if you struggle to put together a matching outfit every morning, you'll still get something out of the documentary, Dior and I. Though if you are into fashion, you'll absolutely love it. The piece is beautifully put together and features cameos by numerous Hollywood stars. But what really makes it engaging is its indulgent look into a niche world that many people never get access to. And there are even some stakes involved as Raph Simons works to pull together his first collection at the Dior Fashion House. Directors. Frederick Chung Year, 2014 runtime, 90 minutes rating. Are chicken people you've heard of show dogs? If you're a fan of Charlotte's Web, maybe you've even heard of show pigs. But would you believe that there's also such a thing as show chickens? Yep, it's an entire competitive world in which people breed and raise poultry specifically for presentation and competition. The documentary has the zany pitch of a comedy, but that just makes it all the more amazing to realize that the bizarre world it depicts is actually real. Directors. Nicole Lucas Hames Year, 2016 runtime, 83 minutes rating. Not rated Sour Grapes technically, Sour Grapes is a crime documentary, but that designation really doesn't do justice to how outlandish its story really is. The tale revolves around Rudy Kerniawan, a collector and enthusiast of wine who apparently knew it better than just about anyone, because he sold cheap wines as super expensive varieties instead and got away with it simply by forging the labels. He defrauded his customers out of millions of dollars. But honestly, if you're insisting on the finest wines, shouldn't you make sure you're able to taste the difference? Directors. Jerry Rothwell, Ruben Atlas Year, 2016 runtime, 85 minutes rating, TV 14.